Last two videos we have studied about the growth and decay of charge of a capacitor through a resistor. The next topic is measurement of high resistance by leakage. So we are having a capacitance C. So when a capacitor of capacitance C, capacitor of capacitance C, and having an initial charge Q0, if it is allowed through discharge through a resistor having a resistance R at a time t. So what we are going to study, we are going to have the measurement of high resistance by leakage. So we are having a capacitor. The circuit that is shown, we are having a capacitor, we are having a resistor, we are having a cell of EMF E, we are having three keys, K1, K2 and K3, and we are having a ballistic galvanometer. I think you are very familiar, which you have already studied in your plus 2, a ballistic galvanometer that is denoted by BG, R, C, K1, K2, K3, and you are having a cell of EMF E. Now we are assuming that we are having a capacitor of capacitance C having an initial charge Q0. This having an initial charge Q0, having a resistance R for a time t. So what will be the charge that is remaining on the capacitor? Okay. So the charge that is remaining on the capacitor, which we have already just studied, that is Q is equal to Q0 e raised to minus t by RC, or we are just rearranging Q0 by Q is equal to e raised to t by RC. Q0 by C 1 by, so it will become e raised to t by RC, or just on integration Q0 by Q is equal to t by RC, or you can write it as t is equal to R is equal to t by C log Q0 by Q to the base E. And if we want to convert this base E to the base 10, log to the base 10, you will multiply the denominator by 2.3026. So now we are going to say the working of this circuit. This is a mathematical thing which we have already studied. We are just closed. Now we are saying that if R is high, what will happen? From this mathematical this itself, we can say when R is high, RC will also be high. When R is high, we know that RC will also will be high. And the rate of discharge of the capacitor will be very slow. The rate of discharge of the capacitor will be very slow. Hence, we can determine Q0 by Q from the experiment. That is, R can be calculated. So, once again, we are saying that we are going to have three keys. So, first one, we will keep this K2 and K3 closed. This key and this key. First and the second key. K2 and K3, we are going to keep it open. So, the capacitor is charged when you are pressing the key K1. So, K1 is closed, K2 and K3 is open, but the capacitor starts charging. Okay, that is the first step. Now, next step is K1 is opened and K3 is closed. That is, the middle one is closed and K1 is open and the middle one is closed. So, the capacitor starts discharging through the galvanometer here. So, first you closed K1. What happened? The capacitor charge starts charging. Okay. At that time, K2 and K3 was open. Now, you are opening K1, but you are closing K3. So, what will happen? It will start. The capacitor starts discharging through this galvanometer, and which records the value, say θ0. Okay. Now, this θ0 will be proportional to Q0. θ0 will be proportional to Q0. So, Q0 was the maximum charge. Now, it starts discharging. So, it will be proportional to Q0. Now, the capacitor is again charged to the maximum value, keeping K2 and K3 again open and K1 is again closed. Now K1 is then opened and again K2 is closed for a non-time T, and some of the charge leak through R here. First we have closed K1, this one, these two were open. Next we have opened K1 and closed K3, so again the galvanometer starts, I mean capacitor starts discharging through the galvanometer, and we found that theta 0, that is here the galvanometer reading, theta 0, that was proportional to Q0. Now again the capacitor is charged to the maximum value. We are keeping K3 and K2 as closed, I mean open, and K1 is closed. K1 is closed, again the capacitor starts charging. K3 and K2 was opened. Now instead of K3, the next step we are going to open K2. So what will happen? The capacitor will charge discharging and leaking through R. Okay, it will start leaking through R. So now K2 is opened and at once K3 is closed. The charge Q remaining on the capacitor discharges through the galvanometer. So resulting throw is noted and Q is proportional to theta. Okay, this is the working. K1 is closed, capacitor charged charging. K2 and K3 was opened. Now K3 was closed, keeping K2 and K1 open. That time again the capacitor discharges through galvanometer. Again we are closing K2 and we are opening K2 and K3, closing K1, again the capacitor is charging. Now we are going to open K1 and K3. Last time we have kept K3 closed. Now we are going to close K2 so that the capacitor leaks through, or the charges discharges through this R. And you, here you have recorded theta 0 as proportional to Q0. Here you are recording theta as proportional to Q. Now we are going to we are going to get the expression as Q0 by Q is equal to theta 0 by theta. Okay. Now we are going to substitute and we are getting the series of values for T and theta can be explained, and you can plot a graph between the mean value of T and theta. Okay, thank you.